एंथ्रोपोलॉजी, एंड इकोनॉमिक्स। Right? So now we are going to study about interrelationship between anthropology and economics. So here we also follow that approach. What is anthropology? And what is economics? Right? Then we have to write about their interrelationship means we have to learn about similarities between anthropology and economics, and that similarities on the basis of subject matter, method, and application. Right? So, for the understanding of similarity between the subject matter of anthropology and economics, you can see your syllabus, topic number 3. In topic number 3, we will study economic anthropology. And in economic anthropology, we study about economic activity of mankind. In this topic, we will study about production, consumption, distribution, and exchange. Right? This subject matter already mentioned in our syllabus topic number 3. Another important topic also mentioned in that topic, impact of globalization. On indigenous economy. So first important thing that give us insight about some interrelationship between anthropology and economics. When you are going to study second paper, there are many issues related tribal problem, economic problem of tribal people that is mentioned in second paper, like poverty, indebtedness, low literacy, health problem, nutritional problem, impact of development project on tribal, displacement, rehabilitation, tribal development program. So this important subject matter is not only subject matter of economic anthropology, but it is also a subject matter of economics. So here both have some common subject matter. Second important thing is that on the basis of method, so what is the method of economics, which method economists utilize for the study of economics? Are you familiar? No, I am asking about हाउ एंथ्रोपोलॉजिस्ट इकोनॉमिस्ट स्टडी इकोनॉमिक्स. Which method economist utilize for the study of economy? Suppose any economist who want to study Indian economy, how can they study Indian economy? No, I am asking economics, not I am asking on anthropology. Here I am asking what is the approach, which important approaches followed by economist for the study of economics. So economist followed social survey method, economic survey, statistical method, mathematical method for the study of economics, right? How we are doing calculation of GDP? How we calculate our national income? So we are gathering data related economics, and that data we gathered through social survey, through economic survey. So social survey and economic survey method is the core method for the study of economics. But in economic anthropology, we also utilize that. Try to understand. Suppose, when you try to study about poverty, situation of poverty in scheduled tribe, how can we collect your data? How much people belongs from scheduled tribe are under poverty line? So we are going to do social survey or economic survey in tribal society, and through that we are gathering our data. So in economic anthropology and economics, we are using social survey method or economic survey method for data gathering. And knowledge gathered by economic anthropologist and economics are utilized for the solution of economic problem of mankind. Right? It is useful for the solution of economic problem of mankind. So on the basis of that, three important aspects we can make interrelationship between anthropology and economics, or similarity between anthropology and economics. Then we have to understand about differences. So here we can make differences between anthropology and economics on the basis of their subject matter, their method, and their application. Because when you try to understand about the subject matter of anthropology, it is a holistic science. In anthropology, we study all dimensions, all aspects of mankind. While in economics, we mainly study economic aspect, right? Economic aspect is the subject matter of economics. But when we are going to study anthropology, we will study about human biological evolution, biological variation, human ecology, human environment, history, society, political system, economic activity, human behavior, human psychology, culture and personality. These are the subject matter of anthropology. Right? So first you make differences between anthropology and economics. In anthropology is the holistic study of mankind, economics is the study of human activity. Second, the scope of anthropology is wider, the scope of economics is narrower. Third, anthropologists interested to study about primitive economy, right? Primitive economy, because anthropologists mainly interested to study about economy of tribal people, economy of simple society, economy of rural society, while economist mainly interested to study about economic activity of modern industrial society. Here they study economic activity of mankind according to socio-cultural perspective. We try to understand economic activity of simple people, primitive people, according to their culture, because their economic activity is deeply interlinked with their culture. Right? As for example, when Maler Paharia go to do shifting cultivation, they worship their Goshain before going to do shifting cultivation. They worship their Goshain after cultivation. But in economy, modern economic system, our economy is not deeply interrelated with our culture. We do our economic activity for the fulfillment of economic need, not for the fulfillment of social or cultural need. So here, that is different. Next, in anthropology, participant observation. Always remember that participant observation is main method. While in economics, economics is based on mainly a statistical method, mainly mathematical method, and application knowledge and data gathered by anthropologists have more application than economics. So on the basis of that, you can make differences between anthropology and economics. And lastly, you can write your conclusion. There are fundamental differences between anthropology and economics. But about that differences, both disciplines are deeply interrelated with each other because both are complementary to each other. Right? More useful economic anthropology. Because in economic anthropology, we study primitive economy as well as modern economy. But in economics, we only study modern economy. So recently, the scope of economic anthropology is also become very wider. Now economic anthropologists are interested to study about primitive economy as well as modern economy. How primitive economy is useful for contemporary society, right? This is the question. That study is useful for the solution of various practical problems of our contemporary society. And first important practical problem is that want to develop our tribal society for national integration, for social development, for economic development. So economic anthropology gives us very good insight. How can we make policy program for tribal development? How can we implement that program in tribal people? and how can we evaluate that program. Second important problem is that basically in our country also we want to establish industry in particular region, but we all know that our tribal people live in that region, which region is very rich natural resources, which region has very rich natural resources. So we want to establish industry in that area, but for the establishment of industry, tribal displacement is must. And recently there are development of demonstration against industrialization in tribal area, right? Because in our country there are no proper rehabilitation policy, displacement policy in our country. So there are many industrial projects which is not being completed due to that problem. So if we can understand economic anthropology, that give us insight how we develop our tribal society to we develop our nation, because both are integrated thing. If any society that want to develop their nation, their society, if we follow regional approach for the development, economic development, so you can also develop our nation, right? So economic anthropology give us insight about that. We can develop our society through the development of our poor people, through the development of our tribal people. So if you try to establish particular industry in particular tribal region, you have to make policy how can more and more tribal people benefited through that industry. Our goal should be how to develop that society, because that society is most poorer society in our society. So we study economic anthropology and that give us insight how can we solve that problem. Another thing is that primitive economy is based on the concept of sustainable development. That is based on the concept of sustainable development. And we are studying about the concept of sustainable development. We want to establish our economy on the concept of sustainable development, but we are facing various problems. So that study gives us insight about how to develop our economy on the concept of sustainable development. Another major problem arises in contemporary society due to industrialization and globalization. Globalization has very worse effect on tribal society, rural and poorer society. So how can we make globalization on the basis of development with human face, or globalization of with human face? That insight we get from the study of economic anthropology. So that section of anthropology, that branch of anthropology, is very useful for the solution of our practical problem, right? But here I want to say that today that economic anthropologist also study about modern complex economic system. Now there are integration between economic anthropology and economics, right? Because if you look out about your topic number 3, in which there is a topic, formalist and substantivist debate, right? Formalist and substantivist debate. What is this? Basically, this debate arises in anthropology. Some economic anthropologists think that theory developed in economics, method developed in economics, approach developed in economics are useful for the study of primitive economy. Right? Means by the application of the theory of demand and supply, by the application of the theory of scarcity of resources and selection of need, by the application of the theory of maximization of profit, by the study of role of market and trade, we can better understand about primitive economy. Because due to globalization, due to industrialization, there are rapid interaction between primitive economy and modern economy. Now, tribal people integrated with monetary economic system. Right? They are integrated with market-based economy. They are not fully isolated. Their economy is in the course of changing. So, if their economy is in the course of changing pattern, then the concept and theory which developed by economists are useful for the understanding of primitive economy. So many economic anthropology or anthropologists, they are working for the understanding of modern economic system. How can we solve problem arises in modern economic system on the basis of a study of economic anthropology or anthropology, right? So it is useful for contemporary society. It is more useful than economics. Basically, in economics, we mainly study modern economic system, right? And in economic anthropology, we study both primitive as well as modern economic system. So that gives us better insight for the understanding of contemporary problem. Right? You can better understand our contemporary problem. We can provide better solution for our contemporary economic theory of anthropology. Right? So now you can write about interrelationship between anthropology and economics. Interrelationship between anthropology and economics. Likhiye. Anthropology is the holistic study of mankind, while economics mainly deals with the study of economic activity of mankind. economic activity of mankind but both discipline are deeply interrelated with each other. पैराग्राफ चेंज कर लीजिए. बेसिकली इकोनॉमिक एंथ्रोपोलॉजी इज द ब्रांच ऑफ एंथ्रोपोलॉजी विच इज डीपली इंटररिलेटेड with each other, which is deeply interrelated with each other, because both disciplines because both disciplines are interested both disciplines are interested to a study of human economic activity. Human economic activity in economic anthropology and economics in economic anthropology and economics we study about we study about production of economic goods and service, production of economic goods and service, consumption, distribution and exchange, technology, labor organization, labor organization, impact of globalization on indigenous economy, impact of globalization on indigenous economy, etc. And both economic anthropologists and economists, both economic anthropologists and economists are using social survey method or economic survey method for the study of their subject matter. For the study of their subject matter and knowledge and data gathered by anthropologist and knowledge and data gathered by anthropologist are useful for the solution of economic problem of contemporary society. Economic problem of contemporary society. Therefore, both anthropology and economics deeply interrelated with each other. But both have fundamental differences. Both have fundamental differences, right? You can write differences in such way first. Anthropology is the holistic study of mankind, and economics mainly concerned with the study of economic activity. Economic activity of mankind. Right? Second, a scope of anthropology is wider because anthropologist interested to study about human biological evolution, biological variation, cultural evolution, society, political organization, human behavior, economy, and a scope of economics is narrower because economics mainly interested to study about economic activity of mankind. Right? Economics mainly interested to study about economic activity. Third, economic anthropologists mainly interested to study about primitive economy. Economic anthropologist is mainly interested to study about primitive economy, and economics mainly interested to study about modern complex economy. Modern complex economy. Right? Next, anthropologists study economic activity of mankind according to socio-cultural perspective. According to socio-cultural perspective. And economics study economic activity of mankind according to economic perspective. Economic perspective. Next, एंथ्रोपोलॉजिकल स्टडी इज मेनली बेस्ड ऑन फील्डवर्क मेथड. बेसिकली पार्टिसिपेंट ऑब्जर्वेशन. एंथ्रोपोलॉजिकल स्टडी इज मेनली बेस्ड ऑन फील्डवर्क मेथड. फील्डवर्क बेसिकली ऑन पार्टिसिपेंट ऑब्जर्वेशन. फाइल इकोनॉमिस्ट मेनली यूजिंग स्टैटिस्टिकल एंड मैथमेटिकल मेथड. स्टैटिस्टिकल एंड मैथमेटिकल मेथड फॉर द स्टडी ऑफ देयर सब्जेक्ट मैटर. मेनली यूजिंग स्टैटिस्टिकल एंड मैथमेटिकल मेथड फॉर द स्टडी ऑफ देयर सब्जेक्ट मैटर. एंड लास्टली नॉलेज एंड डेटा गैदर बाई एंथ्रोपोलॉजिस्ट. नॉलेज एंड डेटा गैदर बाई एंथ्रोपोलॉजिस्ट knowledge and data gathered by anthropologist are useful for the solution of biocultural, social, political, behavioral, economic problem of mankind. Economic problem of mankind, social, cultural, political, behavioral, economic problem of mankind. And knowledge and data gathered by economists are mainly useful for the solution of economic problem of mankind. Right? Paragraph change. Therefore, both anthropology and economics have fundamental differences but instead of these differences both anthropologist and economist, both anthropologist and economist are working together for better understanding of economic problem of contemporary society. Therefore, both disciplines are deeply interrelated with each other because both are complementary to each other. Because both are complementary to each other.